Hello, Jan Marks. Welcome to my office. Would you care to sit down?
No, Miss Vili, I will stand. This isn't going to take too long. Also, I prefer that you refer to me as Superannuated Mayor Marks.
Very well, Mrs. Marks. The first question is quite obvious. Why are you running again? The last time you ran for mayor, you lost to someone who has brought terrible damage and shame to San Luis Obispo. If you were to prevail, you'd be 80 years old by the end of your term. What's this all about?
I think I can make a difference.
What sort of difference? To be honest, your campaign appears to be driven by your ego. A need for power, and a need to be recognized.
I think I could help fix SLO.
How so, in all sincerity? Let's take a look back at your past tenure as San Luis mayor and council person.
Must we? Is that really necessary?
Yes, it's only fair. Back in 2011 and earlier, you were the clandestine vice president and treasurer of a nefarious group known as Citizens for Planning Responsibly. Do you acknowledge that?
If I must, that was a long time ago. My memory is fuzzy.
As vice president and treasurer Citizens for Planning Responsibly, you underhandedly blocked development of the Delidio Ranch project along the 101, on the south end of town. As a result, this drove development along Los Osos Valley Road at Froom Ranch Road, which was of course the group's intent, along with protecting Tom and Jim's pet projects in the downtown area. In the end, the negative impact of your antics to San Luis has been great.
I don't really recall that. It was a long time ago.
As a result of your underhanded dealing, the former Delidio property is still going to be developed. This time by Gary Grossman, who will develop the land in a far more dense manner, in order to service the nearly $20 million he paid for it. In addition, the taxpayers and not the developer will largely be on the hook for the Prado Road overpass construction. I have to ask, how did you escape being indicted, and how do you sleep at night?
Well, back then I had real power, which allowed me to escape indictment. That power is something I want to restore. I can sleep anytime, and I often do.
So in reality, it's a matter of regaining power and not serving the city of San Luis.
Did I say that? Off the record that might be true, but I would never admit to it on the record.
Let's move along to the issue which likely caused you to lose your last election to Harmon. Your infamous rental housing inspection program. Just how did you come up with such a piece of crap? Both renters and landlords hated it. What was your reasoning behind it? Who advised you on the matter?
Well, I thought it was a good idea at the time. Remember, John Ashbaugh and Carolyn Christensen also voted for it. I didn't pass it by myself.
That begs the next question. Doesn't San Luis deserve better governance than that provided by you and Carolyn Christensen, who is still on the city council? Shouldn't you remain retired, and shouldn't Christensen join you and Ashbaugh in retirement in 2022? Given your past performances?
Again, off the record, it would probably be best for the city if a clean slate of fresh and able individuals were elected. I must admit I'm impressed by the resumes of Sweeney and Torres and that of Mr. Eric Long. But if I admitted that on the record, doing so would not serve my ego, which desires to be back on the SLO City Council.
So finally we get to the truth.
What do you mean?
Never mind. I'm curious. Do you ever worry about being taken seriously, given your past performance?
Not really. Should I?
Let's move on. Back when you were mayor, you also said you wanted the city to buy up houses, and in turn, rent them out. We didn't hear anything more about your schema after it became clear that the houses in question were being rented by students in your own neighborhood, where you live. It sounded as if you wanted to use the city to gentrify your own neighborhood. What do you have to say about that?
I don't recall. I was volunteering for the Sierra Club at the time and I had a lot on my mind. I got in trouble there too when I forgot to file some important paperwork. It was a dark time.
Should we expect more dark times if you are elected once more to the city council?
I refuse to answer your question on the grounds that it would likely incriminate me.
Oh, good grief. Okay. I'm curious about your take of the current times in San Luis. What do you think about the current mayor's efforts, and those of her minions, to entice BLM members to come to San Luis to act like violent animals.
Well, that's her shtick, and it has blown up in her face. If a candidate doesn't pack the proper gear for office to begin with, then they need gimmicks to get elected and to remain in office. Just where do you think the rental housing inspection program came from?
Aha. The truth comes out.
That's off the record.
The hell it is. Okay, one final question. What do you think of the current mayor's attack on the local district attorney?
Even I'm not foolish enough to try and sell such a pack of lies. That's saying a lot.
Indeed it is.
What's that supposed to mean? Anyway, I need to take off and head to Home Depot. I need to pick up some replacement blades for my box cutter. Cutting through vinyl really dulls them quickly.
Nice talking to you again, Superannuated Mayor Marks.
Good day, Mrs. Philly.